students, good morning. In this video we are going to explain nationalism in Europe part 3, and in the last video we explained you about the France society, which comprised three groups are there: first, second, third estates. How the first, second estate people harassed the third estate common people, we observed in the last unit. Now we are going to see the third part of the lesson, nationalism in Europe. This is part 3, and in this lesson we are going to learn about the reasons of French Revolution. Reasons of French Revolution. And we see what were the reasons behind the French Revolution. The first one, growing of middle class. I told you French society comprised three estates are there: the clergy and the noble and the common people. It means the kings and the rich persons live in first estate, whereas nobles, landlords, church officials, popes, bishops live in second estate. And I told you all the professional workers, teachers, doctors, lawyers, engineers, and the agricultural works, industrial workers, peasants, artisans belong to third estate. And in this third estate, number of educated people are there. Best example, teachers, doctors, lawyers, engineers are coming under educated group. This educated group in the third estate are collectively form into middle class. And they learned education already. They know what is right, what is wrong. And they had been observing what were the wrong works done by France kings. That's why they are unable to tolerate the wrong works and illegal works done by France kings. That's why they wanted to revolt against French rulers' despotism and French rulers' monarchical way. And to get the revolt, the middle class people, which we known as the professional group people, all the educated people revolted. And before the revolution, in the France society, number of social and political incidents also occurred. And among those, the main demand of the common people, who are the educated, the main demand of educated was liberalism. If we see what is the meaning of liberalism, the word liberalism is derived from a Latin word liber, which means freedom. It means liberalism is nothing but a different type of administration which is giving a limited power in the hand of the leader, and the power is enjoying by the leader of the country on the advice of the people. It means people are giving more power, more priority, and leaders are giving less priority, less importance in this liberalism. And through liberalism, the people demanded right to vote, the people demanded freedom to move in the country. And through liberalism, people also demanded to develop the country on education, culture, tradition, and introduction of modern science. In all these important things. So liberalism is also an important demand of France people. But liberalism was not liked by the leaders, because leaders of France required and they expected total power in the country, and they don't like to give any rights in the hands of people. That's why One side, the France people demanded liberalism, and the other side, the France leaders, they expected the monarchy or despotism. That's why a severe struggle was going on between the liberal demanding persons, common people in the France, and the monarchical demanding kings. Ultimately, kings did not accept for the provision of liberalism in France. And we have to see growing of middle class is one reason and demand of liberalism one more reason. If we see the third one, socialism, birth of socialism was also an important reason of French Revolution. Because socialism, we know already in the previous videos, it is a concept of a system of the government which is removing successfully the economical imbalances between haves and have-nots. Purely a country which is to be called as a socialist country, a country does not comprise the economical imbalances between poor and rich. Already we saw lot of differences between the rich and landlords and the poor people of France. That's why every France people had a dream of removing of the economical differences between haves and have-nots. So to achieve this aim, they participated in the French Revolution in order to achieve the concept of socialism. And number four, we have to see England and the American revolutions. We know England revolt, which was also called Bloodless Revolution, also called Glorious Revolution, which occurred in 1688. Without shedding of a single drop of blood, the England people achieved the revolution and they introduced a parliamentary system in the country. In the same way, suppose we go to American Revolution, which was occurred in 1783. And what was the slogan of American revolt? No taxation without representation. No taxation without representation. So, this England revolt and American revolt methods greatly inspired the France people and they injected the ideas of liberty, equality, fraternity and justice. So, France people fought for achievement of these four ideals and that's why these all reasons paved a way for the French revolt. Ultimately, French revolt occurred in 1789. And July 14th, what we told you, the starting point of the French Revolt occurred by broke opening of the Bastille Fort. What we told you in the last video, by people broke open the Bastille Fort and expressed their revolt. And ultimately, they removed the Louis XVI and they announced France as a republic country. So ultimately in 1789, France announced as a republic country. But after announcing France as a republic, number of political, social, economical changes occurred in France. And these changes are caused for two more revolts tested by France. I told you in the beginning, France experienced three revolts. One was 1789 and the second one was 1830 and the third one was 1848, which we know as respectively 1830 revolt was to be called as July revolt and 1848 revolt was to be called as February revolution. And the 1830 revolt occurred in the period of Charles X, whereas Louis Philippe's time, 1848 French Revolt was occurred. And now we are going to see after 1789 what were the political changes occurred in France. 1789 when revolt occurred, 1789 up to 1791, the 2 years France people engaged in drafting of the French Constitution, and the French Constitution gave top priority for equality, liberty, fraternity, and justice. It also provided right to vote to the people through this constitution. But of course, this right to vote was not live long, many years. And in 1791-92, the liberal government was established in France, and the people were ruled by the liberal leaders. I already told you what is the meaning of liberalism. And in 1793-94, in this period, Jacobins occupied the France. If we see who were Jacobins, Saint Jacob was the founder of Jacobins Club, and Jacobins elected Robespierre as their leader. And 1793-94, Jacobins occupied the France, and they established a ferocious rule in France. And by this ferocious rule, common people were not given any chance to question the leaders. And who questioned the leaders were severely given punishment, and in place of the public grounds, they were killed. And ultimately, all the France people criticized the crimes done by Robespierre against the France people. And Saint Jacob, who was the founder of Jacobins Club, they met in the coffee tea clubs in the France and encouraged all the people against the existed government in France. That's why the government resigned and the power was given to Jacobins. But Jacobins did not rule the France people in a proper way. That's why their leader Robespierre was, in a short period afterwards, he was guillotined. Guillotine means what we told you in the lower classes, a mission. And it was invented by a man who was named Guillotin. That's why, with the help of the mission, the people who were accused by the court, accused by the king, would be punished. And even ultimately, Robespierre was accused by the court, and he was guilty, and he was guillotined. And after 1794, in the year of 1795, the France ruling power was given to the Directory Board. Directory Board comprised 5 members were there. But unluckily, these 5 members quarreled for presidential post. There was no unity among the Directory Board people. And when the Directory Board people quarreled themselves, it was the right time expected by one more important notorious person, Napoleon Bonaparte, and who had taken the power by arresting all the Directory Board members and captured the France power. It means after Directory Board failure in the country, Napoleon Bonaparte came into power. And he became the leader of France. Napoleon ruled France under the designation of France Army Commander. And he ruled from 1795 up to 1798. Napoleon was a warrior, and he continuously did the wars, and he participated in a number of internal wars. And in no war, he was defeated by any other person. That's why people's confidence was increased on Napoleon. And they feel, ultimately, Napoleon was the right person to become the leader of France. and in 1798 first time Napoleon participated in Nile War was occurred between the English naval commander Nelson and the France commander Napoleon. But unluckily, this was the first time Napoleon was defeated in the Nile War by the hand of Nelson, the British naval commander. And the war was occurred in the country Egypt in the river bank of Nile. And this was the first defeat which was unable to digest by the Napoleon and by the Napoleon following persons. That's why Napoleon wanted to hide this issue, and he told a lie to his country people that he won in the war. Though he was actually defeated in the Nile War, he told to his country people that he won in the war. And it was a common issue. That's why every time Napoleon won in the war, that's why the France people also believed that Napoleon only won in the Nile War. But actual incident is reverse. Napoleon was defeated by the hand of Nelson. So Napoleon did not explain about his defeat to the France people, and he convinced them that he was the winning in the war. He was the winner in the war. And afterwards, he wanted to make his post permanent in the France. And to take this action, what he has to do, number of political economical activities, changes, reforms implemented by him. Now we have to see the students. 1798, in the year of 1798, Napoleon was defeated in the War of Nile. But I told you, he hid the issue and he told that he was won in the war. And after coming back to the France people respected him as a savior. Because so many years onwards, France people respected Napoleon. That's why they welcomed Napoleon as a savior. That's why under this shadow of welcoming or the respect receiving by Napoleon wanted to safeguard his post as a permanent one. And after 1 year, in the year of 1799, he wanted to announce continental system. Napoleon announced continental system. It means, what is the meaning of continental system? Already we learned Napoleon was defeated in the Nile War by the hand of Nelson, who was the British naval commander. Now, though people praised him, an important sorrowful incident is creating pain in his mind. What was the painful incident? His defeat by the hand of Nelson. That's why he knew very well he was unable to defeat the England naval commander directly. That's why he wanted to take revenge on the England in an indirect way. So to defeat England in an indirect way, Napoleon introduced a master plan that was to be named as Continental System. Under this system, his main aim was what? Make the England as an isolate country and make the England as a weak country. Why he wanted to make England as a weak country? So his aim was, he has to take the chance as the leader of France and to beat the England severely. His main aim is to take revenge on England and not to give chance to England in order to dominate on France. That's why he wanted to make England as a weak country. And he ordered all the countries. It means the situation was entire the European continent was favored to Napoleon. How it was favored? Because the remaining countries, neighboring countries also, they know very well about the France leader Napoleon's strategy. That's why they underwent the policy of Napoleon, and they had no courageous to say no to the Napoleon. That's why whatever the order coming from the Napoleon's side, remaining countries are ready to accept it. That's why Napoleon ordered all the countries not to take any business, economical, political relationship with England. Though it was disliked by all the countries, suppose they do not follow, the countries feel that Napoleon might have taken any action on the country which is not accepting the Napoleon's order. That's why though it was disliked by all the countries of European continent accepted the Napoleon's order, and they did not continue relations with England. And without coming of any country with the economical contact with England, the England's economical position came into bankruptcy. The trade, the business, the exports, imports, all with the England country were completely come down. England slowly observed what were the incidents going on, what were the things going on, changing in the entire European continent, and who were the man in back of all these incidents. And they observed Napoleon was main responsible of keeping their country England as an isolate, aloof. And that's why they wanted to take revenge on the Napoleon in the right time. They had been waiting for a chance. And after 5 years, from 1799, under the presence of Pope Pius VII, Napoleon was announced himself as the dictator of France. And in the year of 1804, Napoleon introduced an important common civil code named as Napoleonic Code. Napoleonic Code means the common civil code which was introduced by Napoleon. And what were the important things in this Napoleonic Code we are going to learn. And by this code, he stopped completely the provisions based on birth. So, through this 1804 Napoleonic Code, Napoleon banned the all provisions based on birth. And he simplified the administration, and he also changed the currency, which is common to all the Europeans. And he also developed transportation, and he improved educational facilities, and he removed serfdom. From France, and he constructed a number of industries in France, and he improved the condition of laborers, and he increased salaries of the workers. In this way, number of welfare programs were completed by Napoleon in order to attract the France people. And he ruled from 1804 up to 1815, a period of 11 years. And by this, Napoleon became a ruler, original ruler of the France. And we are observing in this story, Napoleon, who was coming and starting his career as a common soldier, and slowly how he was promoted from common soldier to brigadier, brigadier to lieutenant general to colonel, colonel to the major general, and major general to supreme commander in chief of army, and in the last from the chief of army up to the dictator of France. So Napoleon ruled as a dictator from 1799 up to 1815. And 1799 up to 1815, and what were the remaining incident happened in France, we are going to learn in our next video. Thank you for watching.